Oh God, it's so big. Oh, that's a radiator? That's not a radiator. That's a radiator. We thought, look at this thing. If it can cool a car, then surely it can cool a gaming PC, right? We only have to solve the minor challenge of figuring out how to put this in this. It can't be that hard, can it? Just like it's not that hard to tell you about our sponsor. Crucial has been making high quality memory and SSDs for over 20 years, and with their Crucial System Scanner tool, finding the perfect parts for your system is easier than ever. Check out Crucial at the link in the video description. The thing about water cooling is that it's not magic. You can water cool something, that is to say, have liquid flowing through tubes and blocks and radiators and pumps, and still have it thermal throttle if you set it up with a water cooling system that isn't adequate for the amount of heat output. Unlike an air cooling solution, you might not see the problem right away, but you can see in our system right here, where we've got a dual 120mm radiator hooked up to a Core i7-9900K and an RTX 3090, that our thermals are starting to get away from us. I mean, if we wanted our CPU to run at 80 plus degrees, why wouldn't we just put a decent heatsink on it? That's because while water is excellent at moving heat around, you still need something in a water cooling loop to take that heat and dissipate it to the surrounding environment. So that's where the radiator comes in. Now, the conventional wisdom is that there's sort of like a limit to how much radiator you need before you start to reach the point of diminishing returns. But I don't believe in fairy tales like that. Well, I do actually, but suffice to say, we're doing this anyway. Alex, come on in, because we gotta figure out a way to make this thing fly. Alex, why don't we start with what this thing is?
So this is the cheapest car radiator from Napa Auto Parts. It's out of a PT Cruiser, $170. That's why we bought it.
But I'm a little confused because it's actually got what seems to be dual loops built right into it.
Yeah.
So you've got an inlet and an outlet here. And then I did a quick blow test on it before we started and determined that it has a second loop. It's got a second loop here and here. Why would that be?
So this is for your engine. It goes from up to down. And then we also have the transmission, which goes across here, but like, I don't quite understand how this one cools things.
Why don't we focus on this puppy then?
We could also just go from here to here and just do the whole thing and say, screw it.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Yeah.
So we go in here, out here, into here and out of here.
Yeah, and maybe even put like a pump in the middle just for fun.
We won't need it. That's a D5, baby. It's a D5. Before we do any of that, however, we of course need to flush our new radiator to avoid voiding the warranty. Hey, at least this confirms the flow path for us.
Oh yeah, look at that.
Doing a little pee there. You know what, Alex? This might tell us what parts of the radiator are like being cooled by this water.
You're also pouring water off over the whole thing.
Yeah,
right,
it's all pretty cold. Oh, it's heavier now. We needed a bigger sink in here. Okay, there we go. Perfect. Okay, I'm back. It works. How do we want to mount it?
I had a couple ideas. The one that I like the most, because it's kind of just the most dumbest, is to just put it right on top like that.
Uh-huh, I mean, we've got these handy mounting pegs, one of which kind of sort of fits there.
Yeah, and then I was thinking just like metal down here, straight across, and then just steel strapping onto the top of the case.
So it's kind of like a performance fin.
Yeah, like we could use this. That would make my life a bit easier for attaching it to here. Yeah, we could have it come off at an angle, and then have a flat plate on the bottom, I guess. Okay, I actually just had an even better idea. So we can still use that L bracket stuff, but then we can attach it to this good old 80-20, create a little frame that goes on top, and then we're able to steel strap that down. It's gonna be, I was gonna say beautiful, but it's gonna be something. I just brought out this bin called T-Slot Hardware. It looks like that it might have solved all of our problems. We have a whole bunch of these brackets that must have been leftovers from one of Colin's projects. And I think we're just gonna use those and call it a day. You know what, this might actually turn out a lot better than I expected. Still not great, but better than I expected.
My side's done. It's at least hand tight. Are we going any tighter than hand tight or?
No, hand tight's fine for now.
All right, cool.
So now, bolts and these things. Very, very loose. This should just go on right down here. Yeah. Oh, you piece of crap.
I mean, if it's a piece of crap, shouldn't we look to the craftsman?
I'm not saying it's good.
Or should I say crapsman?
I'm gonna blame 80-20 for all of my problems from now on.
Which 80-20? Like 80-20 aluminum or the 80-20 rule? 20% of the effort that gets you 80% of the result?
Okay, yeah, we are definitely going low effort on this. We're all about reduce, reuse, recycle here today. This is our mouse testing robot. So, well, not a robot, our mouse tester. Hammer goes, turns on a light so that you know exactly when the mouse started moving, but it's outlived its usefulness. And I'm just gonna use parts of it for this. All right, so this is the basic thought. This goes across here. I have no clue if this should be wider or not, but I think it'll be fine. Okay, this should be... Oh my God. Oh, it's even peeing on me. This is so stupid.
Not bad at all. Now all we need to do is get some fans on it.
And plumb it.
Oh, fortunately, we have an easy plan for at least one of those things. We're gonna take these zip ties and run them through our fans like so. Ha, see that?
Two zip ties per fan?
Oh yeah, there, more than that was never an option.
Yeah, we have kind of outdone ourselves here.
I mean, if it's stupid and it works, it's not stupid.
So there's a couple ideas of how to do the tubing. For the transmission one, it's easy. We have just adapters that
Perfect.
Work.
Love it.
For the bigger ones, I have a really terrible idea.
I love it.
So we have a bike inner tube here. I don't know why, but we do. The basic thought was to cut this, stretch it around those right there, use that as a reducer, and then just cover it in tuck tape, probably duct tape, then maybe a towel to soak up the stuff that gets through that, and then wrap it in tuck tape again.
Okay. I don't have a better idea right now.
I hope this works, because that was a bike tire that was destroyed, which would be kind of sad.
Did you kill it already?
Oh yeah, it's dead.
Oh, okay.
It's super dead.
I was hoping to give it a little bit of thought before you destroyed it.
Not so bad.
I've seen dumber stuff under this roof. Maybe more zip ties.
And then let's get a nice long piece of tube to go on there.
You can always tell when it's a Friday and I'm supposed to be hosting WAN show because things get a little...
A little this.
This.
This is a bad one.
Yes, and also no. This isn't even that stupid, now that I see it.
Yeah, a couple of big boys and then a couple of small ones.
Yeah,
for the
I
pinch.
Got it. I'm coming. I see the vision here, Alex. This might actually freaking work. I'm sorry, Alex. I didn't have the right amount of faith in you, and I should have.
Oh, this is what's gonna be doing the transmission cooler loop. This hose clamp might be too big, but I guess we'll find out in a second once I tighten it down a bit. We're like actually not very far off. Wonderful. There's one more.
I can hear the whys coming from around the world. Is there any leak test? Like, we're basically assuming it's gonna leak, aren't we? This is pretty drippy for a case that has an open hole on the top of it. You can't get me a piece of plexi or something, or plywood even.
I guess that would be more smarter.
Don't mind me, I'll just hold this here. A rag. Alex, come on!
I have a better idea.
My arms are getting tired.
I have a different idea. So what we do, you place it on top and then we just put a parts tray underneath it.
No, because it's gonna drip from lots of different places, Alex. For better or for worse, this is a thing that exists now. So am I just disconnecting this thing? Like, why not, right?
I guess so, yeah.
Okay, I mean, it's near the top of the loop. How much water could leak, right?
Quite a bit, I would say.
Well, there's only one way to know for sure. No, no, actually, I think none is gonna leak.
Oh,
here
yeah,
you go,
good.
You ready?
Sure.
Boom, none. See that?
Damn,
yeah,
not bad.
Okay.
Just gonna ratchet strap this down here, you know, gotta be nice and secure. Oh look, just like I planned, we're adding the feature of having a shutoff valve so that you have a shutoff valve right here.
Yeah, just like you planned.
Yes.
Thank goodness we have the 40 ounces now, hey? I'm so ready. You only live once, Alex. Come on, hook me up.
Okay.
Here we go. You ready? The fans aren't turning on. Are they supposed to?
I'm ready. No, they're not plugged in yet.
Hello?
Hello, Mr. Pump.
Oh yeah, it's leaking pretty good. Okay, we need more absorbent materials. Do we have anything reusable? Well, no, I need it on this side. Oh yeah, okay, there we go. Now we're talking.
Okay. This is so bad.
Well, yeah. We never ever thought at any point that this was not going to be bad. Hey, you turned off the power supply.
Yeah, because it was leaking on the top of the computer.
Oh, I mean, that's why we've got wood on there instead of scraps of rag like you were gonna put there.
We've also got scraps of rag.
We do have both. That's redundancy right there, it's protection.
I can't tell if it's leaking less or if it's all just going into that rag.
Oh, it's all going into the rag, it's leaking lots.
Oh.
Wait, am I just filling to compensate for leaks right now?
No.
I would actually like this pump to go at full speed. I'm gonna disconnect the PWM controller majig.
Oh my God, it's so much. Okay, I have a different idea.
There it goes. Whoa, hey-ho, how you doing there, buddy? Oh God, it's so big. Oh, we have a problem. Did you take off your tape?
Yes, okay, should I kill it?
No, that will be worse. We just need more absorbency.
Okay, well, just a second. I'm coming with a fix.
Oh, it's kind of, okay, stop. You need to stop. Can I get another small zip tie? Alex, can you hold this? Or someone, do you have the zip tie by any chance? What a boss. Man, I feel like I'm working on like a field wound.
Okay, do you want to move?
It's a little
bit. Oh wait, the pump's running dry.
Well, I'm working on it, aren't I? Okay, I can't wait for this stupid slow funnel.
Oh my God, this is so bad.
What do you have?
It's aquarium putty.
Wait, you had aquarium putty this whole time? Why am I just finding out about this now? I don't actually know that there's any water in the CPU block, Alex.
Doesn't really look like it. We need more stuff. That's not helping at all. Why did we put it on top?
That was your idea!
It was Andy's idea.
It was not Andy's idea! Don't you blame this on gentle Andy. In response to our earlier query as to whether it's just losing water at this rate, I think it might be. We can't get the water up there. You might have been right about the head pressure. I was so sure that the D5 would come through.
It's a D5!
One thing we can do is we can tip it. Once it's full, the head pressure issue becomes a non-issue. We can also try power cycling it again. Don't hit the computer though. I'm just gonna do the pump real fast. Real fast, real quick styles. Go back on pump. No, see, it's got bubbles in it.
Yeah.
That's why it's not able to do it. Oh, it's full.
Oh, wait, yeah.
Those drips are big and coming from very high. They're hitting this tube, which could put the graphics card in jeopardy, but that's good. I mean, the graphics card being in jeopardy is not good, but the
CPU getting water is good.
Yeah, is the CPU getting water?
It looks like it, yeah. I had a joke in my head before this that I was going to call it a success if we didn't kill any hardware, and it's become a much more real thing than I expected.
Holy crap balls, we have flow. Where's my sweater? LTTstore.com. Okay, made of the finest French terry. Stealth hoodie, LTT Store. I'm starting the stress test. So CPU burner, we were doing 16 threads, right?
Oh.
Alex?
Yes. Okay. Oh my God.
And wait.
There's so much water.
Alex, help me out here. The resolution is 2560 by 1920, right?
Yes.
Okay, where's the CPU burner? Hold on, what were you using to monitor HW info?
Yeah, what are our temps looking like?
I'm checking. I'm on it. Hold on, we're running out of water here, boys. Good God, we are losing a lot of water. Are the fans even running, Alex?
No.
Well, why not? What have you been doing this whole time?
Alex extenders. I've been making sure that we don't kill the system.
Yeah, well, that's going great, isn't it?
It is. It's not dead yet.
Does this have Molex on it? Because we could use this one.
Oh yeah, that works.
Oh wow, this is dripping more than I thought. Andy, do you have footage of this? Yeah, this is all for nothing if we don't capture it on video. Oh crap, the pump's about to run dry. Do we have fan spin?
Nope.
What? No fans are spinning? Oh crap, there's a lot of. What's going on here? I think the pump is not pumping. Shoot, it's overflowing. Come on, pump. Come on, baby. Oh, she's leaking water. We're getting almost no flow to the CPU.
Jumper, fans on, fans not on.
The power supply is not connected to the test bench.
Ah, that would do it.
We have flow to the CPU, CPU temps are holding. Our maximum is 77 degrees.
Okay, that's better than before.
No, no, that was when it wasn't flowing. We are at 67 max right now.
Couple fans.
We got four fans spinning. I just gotta add some more water.
Why are the other ones not spinning?
They could not be hooked up, I don't know. I just started chucking stuff.
Oh my god, this Molex connector is just absolutely gonzo.
At what point do we just rip the pins out and chuck it in?
Okay, I'm gonna find which rags are not wet and move them into spots where rags are wet.
I've got more fans spinning now.
Okay. Good news, our CPU is only 63 degrees. GPU's at 42, so that's also way lower than before.
Okay, all right, we've got six fans spinning. Where's the rest of my fan connectors here? Alex, did you bring enough fan connectors? Oh, come on. Oh my God, do you have side cutters? It's a three pin, the fan's four pin, Alex. Yeah, that's better.
Oh geez, we have another leak.
Okay,
so that needs
anything.
To go. This also needs to go.
Am I spinning another one? It's yep. Got the paper towel in it, Alex. Wait, hold on. That's an industrial. Alex, we gotta top up the water.
Just a second, it's leaking really
no,
bad.
No, it's gonna get all over the table if we don't top up the water.
So the good news is 4.9 gigahertz on, what is that, 8 cores. We're currently at 65 degrees on the CPU, 45 degrees on the GPU, way better than before. This is clearly a win.
You know, Alex, I think that it's gonna be very hard for us to evaluate the efficacy of the radiator when what's actually happening is we are just completely replacing the water with cool tap water every, you know, probably 10 to 15 minutes.
This is PC gaming at its best.
I got another spin.
The good news is that the transmission ones aren't leaking.
That is good news, actually.
Oh geez, the paper towel's become saturated.
Hold on, I need one more extension. Hey, why are you not spinning? Is it spinning now?
Nope.
How about now?
Yeah!
It's the...
Oh.
I don't know how much longer we can keep this running, so we're gonna have to conclude it now. We are at maximum turbo on our CPU, 4.9 gigahertz on all cores effectively, because those threads that we're not using for the CPU burn test are being used by FurMark for the GPU. We are maxed out, so our hottest core is at just 63 degrees. That compares to over 80 degrees with our Wimpy dual radiator. Okay, so that's a big 20 degree improvement. As for our GPU, let's fire up FurMark here. We are sitting right pretty at about 35 degrees. What were we at, 40 before?
No, 60.
60, wow, we've dropped 25 degrees on our GPU and all it cost us was, holy crap, I don't have any water. Alex, we're gonna have to top this up in just a second here. And in terms of like acoustics and convenience factor,
it's pretty loud.
Hey, thanks for watching. This video is brought to you by Privacy. Privacy lets you shop online with virtual credit cards that offer way more security and control than conventional cards. Like, have you ever tried to sign up for a free trial and then forgotten about it, only to find the charges on your account for a subscription service you never really wanted? Well, with privacy.com, you can create a new card just for that trial, and then all you do is designate the card to be single use and set the monthly spending limit to $1 so companies actually cannot charge you, even if you forget about it. Privacy.com is PCI DSS compliant, uses military-grade encryption to secure your information, and offers two-factor authentication. And since they make money from merchants, there's no cost to you. If you sign up today, you'll even get $5 for free. So check it out today at privacy.com/Linus. That's privacy.com/Linus. If you guys enjoyed this video and you really like watching me and Alex work on janky cooling setups, maybe check out the, whoops, Ultimate Air-Cooled Laptop, where we took a laptop and overclocked it to 5 gigahertz with a Blowy Matron cooling fan.
Oh, frig, it's getting on this power supply.
Oh God, it's getting on everything. Okay, we gotta shut this down. We gotta shut it down.
Okay, this is gonna be so bad. Okay, Linus, can you grab the bucket that's over there?
See you later. Can you believe everything survived this ordeal?
Yeah.
Wow, massive props to all the makers of the hardware we used today.